this team coming in as something special, you know? Did you hear about Charlie's time yesterday?
52 minutes and 12 seconds.
Watch out! Come on, Kelly! Help! 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 Watch out! Kelly! Come on, Kelly!
Charlie's time is still holding strong, and he looks a definite threat to the current first place time. Charlie Lanai and his team led by Kavik, looking very good as they cross the finish line with an incredible unofficial time of 71 flat. That's going to be very tough to beat. Impossible.
Mush! Get around now!
But it sure looks like Charlie Lanai.
Where are the drills, Eddie?
I ain't here yet.
That's Bill Connell at the finish now, with an unofficial time of 73.49, which helped to put him close to fourth place.
Eddie, where the heck are the drills?
Well, I talked to Stark, okay? He said they're gonna come in real soon now, okay? Weather held them up, okay?
It didn't hold me up.
You're right. I'll tell him that when I see him.
Don't see him. Cancel the order and get the drills from Dunston.
Oh, you sure about that?
Order the drills from Dunston.
If you say so, sure. Then what?
Then nothing. You're fired.
Mr. Hunter.
I'll give you 4,000 for him.
A dog like this is worth a lot more than 4,000. Kavik's a champion.
Look, I haven't got much time. I'm leaving in half an hour. 4,000, make up your mind. Just yes or no. I'll be in my trailer.
Thank you. Come on, Laura. Good night, Andy. Oh, honey, come on now. 7:30 sharp, Laura.
Andy, you sure you don't want to come with us?
Yes, Mom.
It's supposed to be a funny movie.
I'd rather just stay here.
Okay. See you later.
Bye, Mom.
Where did you hear this is supposed to be a funny movie?
I don't know. I saw it in the poster. It said, well, there was a title and there were some names, and it said, this is a very funny movie.
One of Hunter's folks is picking him up in Copper City. He'll be in Seattle in a couple of weeks. I offered to fly him all the way down to Seattle myself, but Hunter says his boat's going to be there anyway. Hunter must have paid you pretty good money for him. I understand none of the other teams even came close.
None of your business.
Still must have been good money for a winner.
I told you, it's none of your business.
And a storm front, and you're heading 40 miles due south, over.
Smiley to Talk Tower. Yeah, I'm getting bumped around a little up here, but it's nothing I can't handle. We'll keep you advised of my status, though. Over.
Roger, Smiley. That would be appreciated. Over. Talk Tower to CGMRW. We now show heavy to extreme turbulence and a definite storm front on your Delta 3 heading. Suggest you try to climb above it. I can carry you 5,000 feet, over. Tower to CGMRW. I do not show you on the screen, over.
Cougar tracks. It's okay. Good night.
Andy?
Dad!
Andy. Andy, how many times have I told you when you're running your traps, you must be home by dark? Your mom and I were worried sick, son.
I found the plane.
Smiley?
He's dead. I thought the dog was dead, too. The cage was thrown clear. At first, I didn't even see it.
So this is the famous Kavik. Oh, son. Oh, you should have put him out of his misery.
I just couldn't.
Okay. Let's try and get him the rest of the way in. Maybe he'll live that long. Let's get you home so your mom can stop worrying about you. Come on. Put out the fire, son.
There was a cougar trying to get at him.
A cougar, are you sure?
Well, it sure looked like a cougar.
I never heard of a cougar this far north, Andy.
Kurt? Andy? Where have you been? I've been so worried.
Smiley did crash, Laura. Smiley's dead. Andy came across the wreck.
Is this the dog he was carrying?
Yeah. Get him over near the fire, son.
He's still alive.
Easy. Easy. Okay, let him down. Right here. Easy, son. Oh, that's good.
What are you going to do with him?
Not much we can do. Just keep him as warm as possible. Laura, I've got to go down to the cannery and let the other pilots know they can call off the search for Smiley. Then I'll radio George Hunter and let him know we found his dog.
Dad?
Yeah?
What are you going to tell him?
The facts. How I see it. The dog's almost dead, son. I'll have to tell him that. I'll see you later.
I should have put him out of his misery.
No. No, I'm glad you brought him home. You need something to eat?
No, Ma, I'm not hungry.
Andy, please.
Mom, do you have a blanket we can put over him?
I understand, Mr. Hunter.
And he's hurt pretty bad, huh?
Yes, sir.
Well, let me know if it's possible to save him.
Right. Okay, right. Yes, sir. Over and out.
I'm really not very hungry, Mom.
It's all right, honey.
Did you tell Mr. Hunter I found Kavik?
Yes.
Well, what did you tell him?
That, frankly, I didn't think the dog had much of a chance.
What did he say?
He said take the dog out and shoot him.
But he might live. Dad, he's lived this long.
You know better than that, son. Leaving him like he is would be cruel. No, George Hunter told me what to do, and he was right.
What about Dr. Walker?
Vic Walker isn't a vet.
He's a doctor, isn't he?
Precisely, that's what he is. He's a doctor.
And he could make a diagnosis.
Well, I'll go over and see.
Now, wait a minute, Andy. Now, if he says no, that means no.
I really find it amazing that that dog is still alive, don't you?
Who's hurt? Is it your dad?
He's with Mom.
Your mom? What, is it Laura? Come on, come on. tell me about it on the way.
You dragged me out here to look at a dog? A dog? You let me think your mother was sick.
Andy?
I didn't mean to. I just said...
You just let me jump to a conclusion is what you just...
Look, now that you're here, won't you just take a look at the dog?
I'll look at him, but that's it, just that. Just look at him.
Could a good vet bring him through?
Where do you propose to find one?
I don't know.
Look, you want my advice? That dog should be put down.
No! Please?
Vic, won't you try?
Please?
I'll pay you. I've got trapping money saved up, enough to pay you. If I don't have enough, I'll work for you to pay the rest.
Oh, get hold of the other end of the blanket.
We're going the back way through the woods. I don't want anybody seeing this, and I don't want anybody hearing about it either.
My lips are sealed.
Dog's sake. They hear about this. Finished as a doctor, that's for sure. Come on, Kurt, let me get at it.
Yeah.
Everybody out. I mean it, out.
All right, come on, Andy.
Dad, could I stay, please?
Well, if you don't get in my way too much, I suppose you can.
Wait a minute, Vic. There's one thing that's got to be said. Now, Andy, Vic is going to do everything he can for the dog. But if he decides nothing can help Kavik, there's no hope, then he'll have to put him to sleep.
I understand, Dad.
It's important that you do, son.
I understand, sir.
Yeah, that's the way it is, Andy.
Andy, I'll leave your supper on the stove. Vic? Thank you.
Well, don't thank me yet. In fact, don't bother to thank me at all. Just you go and leave me to get on with it, will you?
Victor, good night.
Yeah, good night. I wish I could say it had been a pleasure. Oh, this dog is a mess. You could start by taking your boots off and not tracking all this mess in here, Andy.
Yes, sir.
Guess what he needs now is sleep. So do you, son. Go on home. Go on.
Yes, sir.
Morning, Andy. How's the dog?
Dr. Walker was right. Legs broken and three of his ribs. Pelvis is broken too. He lost an awful lot of blood. Dr. Walker doesn't know if he's gonna make it. Mom?
No, no. You'll be all right, Andy. Look at you, you're exhausted. Need some sleep. Come on.
What about school?
Well, you can go in the afternoon. After you have your lunch, I'll write you a note. Later on tonight, you'll go over to Dr. Walker's and you'll see how the dog's feeling.
His name's Kavik.
Kavik? It's a nice name, Kavik.
Get some rest, Andy.
Okay, Mom.
Oh. Andy get in?
Uh-huh. Dog is pretty sick.
Mom, could you come here a second?
I'm coming. I've put some coffee on.
Oh, thanks.
What is it, honey?
I'm scared.
You don't have to be afraid, honey.
But he might die.
Sleep.
Mom, I really care for him.
There's nothing wrong with caring, Andy. Now you get some sleep, please.
Mom, if you hear from Dr. Walker, wake me up.
I will. Promise. Pretty scared.
He'll be all right, Laura. Even if the dog dies, whatever happens, Andy'll be fine.
You're right.
Vic doesn't want you there during office hours, son. If that's what he wants, then you have to obey his wish.
That's right. Vic Walker does things the way he chooses.
I'll just go up and wash.
I'll go over after supper.
Not until 7:30, you won't.
Yes, Mom.
Walker, what's happened now?
Hello, Vic. Kurt Evans here.
Can you spare a moment?
A moment, sure.
It's about the dog. Andy's already gotten awfully attached to it.
Well, I was just wondering, what do you really think his chances are?
Well, they're no better than 50-50.
50-50, huh?
Sorry, Kurt, I can't tell you anything better.
Well, thanks. I appreciate that.
You come in, Andy. Who, Kavik? He hasn't been awake enough for me to ask him, which I might have done if he'd been a human patient. Here, do you want some cocoa?
What?
Cocoa. Now, you've heard of cocoa, haven't you? Or has your mother deprived you all these years?
I've heard of it. I mean, yes, thank you. I'd like some.
Yeah, well, so would I. So why don't you put some milk in the pan and shove it on the stove?
And keep your eye on it, huh? You hate it when it gets that slippery skin and it all gets in your beard. Miss Murray, clean it out.
Yes, sir. Is he really better?
Well, he's not exactly dancing, is he? Still, I think he's turned the corner. Oh, still, you silly creature. Just trying to help you. Yeah. Now, I think it should take him about a day for his system to realize that it's not getting its food directly anymore. But by tomorrow night, I think he should be ready for a little solid food.
Something to eat. Which one of these do you like?
How about this one here?
This guy here? All right. What shall we give him? A steak or maybe a piece of tail with some meat to chew on?
Dr. Walker said he might not be able to chew very well.
All right, then we'll give him some steak.
Get off of there. Okay. Here we go. One steak coming up.
Come on.
Put it on the floor. I doubt he'll take food from anyone.
You don't have to be afraid of me, Kavik. I'm not going to hurt you.
He's not afraid of you, Andy. He's just being careful. Sick as he is, he's just being real careful.
When's he going to be completely well?
Oh, don't rush things. He's doing fine.
Now, you remember our agreement. Not a peep out of either of you.
Yes, sir. Come on, Kevin.
You're high.
You can eat it.
There's been a rock slide up north. What? You got to fly up with
me. Oh, you're kidding.
Well, how far? I don't... Look, if I go with you, I'll find this in a while. That's what I heard. I'm just telling you. Hold on.
Oh, some fool's got half a mountain fell on him, and their Swede's going to fly me up to see if we can help the man. I don't know how many days I'm going to be. Look, you'd get your father and take Cabby back to your place, huh?
What do we do?
Nothing, I hope. All he really needs now is sleep and food and water. I'll be back in a few days. I'll stop by. And not a word to anyone about where he got his doctoring.
No, sir. We're going home, Kavik. Yeah, we're going home.
Pretty good.
You mean he's gonna be okay?
Oh, I think that you can bet everything you've got on that.
Kevin, did you hear that? You did it, boy. You're gonna be completely better. Yes.
He did it with a little help from Dr. Walker.
Yes, sir. Very good help.
How much do we owe you, Mick?
Dad. I said I'd pay. It was my idea to get Dr. Walker.
Yeah, there, you see, it was his idea. Well, I'm afraid, young man, you owe me $5.
I'll get it for you right now.
Good.
Yeah, tell him that I had a rum, will you? I mean, he can bring it around anytime. Anytime at all.
Vic.
Yeah, going up late.
Victor.
Oh.
Thanks, Vic.
Why is it that Vic is so afraid to let people see he's kind?
Well, Vic is gone, son. You can take it to him later.
Okay. Just look at him. Isn't he wonderful?
You don't have to tell George Hunter yet.
He has to know the animal's recovered.
Well, he hasn't. Not yet. Just a little more time?
sooner or later, we've got to accept that that dog is going back to George Hunter.
This morning.
You look pretty good yourself.
Oh, well, yeah. Unfortunately, I have to go to work.
Unfortunately.
I'll see ya.
Okay, honey. Got your lunch?
Yep.
Good.
Kavik! Come on, son. How are you? Hey. Well, come on. Come on. Atta boy. Come on. Waiting for Andy, huh, Kavik? Oh, he'll be along, son. Come on. Atta boy, atta boy. All right. Come on, I'm going to work down here. You want to go with me? You want to work? Huh?
I'll tell you, it's frustrating working down there without the right tools. Well, I'm gonna get out of the weather.
Appreciate you helping me out, Andy.
Oh, that's okay, mister.
Well, now, let me get a good look at your dog here. Hiya, fella. You're a big one, aren't you? I heard you had him. I wondered if we were ever going to get to see him or not.
Well, he was awfully sick.
What's his name again?
Kavik.
He sure looks like a winner. Can understand why George Hunter bought him.
I can, too.
Well, I better be getting back to work myself, Andy.
Okay.
See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Hiya, Dora. How you doing?
Come on, Kavik.
Andy! Oh, what's that? Where did you find him? Out in one of your trap lines?
He was in a plane wreck.
Hunter's dog. Hunter's dog's the one that won the big race up by Toke.
Oh, not the championships.
Not the championships. No, the earlier race. You know, the one they arranged together? So this was in Smiley's crash, huh? I didn't think the dog made it, though. It's got some kind of Eskimo name, right?
Kavik.
Kavik?
It means Wolverine.
Wolverine? Doesn't look like a Wolverine to me. You know what a Wolverine looks like, though, Andy? It's a small little animal with big teeth. You know, they're ferocious. They're terrible. That's the wrong name for him, too. Who named him?
I don't know.
Oh.
He's big.
I know he's big. He's probably got wolf in him. He's probably got wolf in him, right, Andy?
I guess.
Yeah. What the? I've seen it, but I don't believe him.
Whoa.
Andy, the Wolverine scored out that way. Why, you believe that?
Kevin!
You better change his name. Even old Rags got a piece of him.
Kevin, come back here.
Rabbit would be more like it.
Rabbit's no good. Good rabbits would have killed him on.
I don't really mind his being a coward, but he even ran away from Rags. He's five times as big, and he ran.
Andy, you're being awfully hard on him.
He ran like he was scared to death.
Andy, come here. Give me yourself. Sit down here. I want to talk to you. You'll be hearing talk one of these days, and I'd rather you heard it from me.
What kind of talk?
About me not wanting to go back to fishing.
Fishing boats cost lots of money.
No, that's not the real reason. There were people willing to finance me, even George Hunter. He offered me the Chinook Maid. No, it's something else. When we lost our old boat, something happened. Oh, I'd been in wrecks before, but when Freedom went down, when she sank, I just sort of lost confidence in myself. I knew I should get up and try again, but I just couldn't.
But maybe it would never happen again.
I know that. Here. But in here, I'm scared.
Dad.
I'm not ashamed of it, son. A man can just take so much of a beating and he's whipped.
Is that what the crash did to Kevin?
Been up at the airstrip. These two surveyors just flew in. I had to pick them up.
Surveyors?
Come on, Evans. Let's go.
Yeah, they're doing some work inland for Mr. Hunter.
Does that mean Mr. Hunter will be coming, too?
I don't know.
Maybe he won't come. Maybe he won't come at all this year.
Well, he'll be here eventually, Andy. Now, we'll deal with that when the time comes, all right?
Okay.
Okay. How'd trapping go?
It was okay.
Okay, I'll see you.
Bye, Dad. Kavik? Okay, now. I gotta go to school. Okay?
Okay, Mr. Norton.
Hi, Pinky. How you doing?
In the pink.
Kurt.
Come here. That's quite the dog young Andy found.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Not the kind of dog I'd run around with, you know?
Well, I think Kavik suits Andy just fine.
I'm curious, Kurt. You know, it seems to me a dad would want to give his son a real dog, you know? Not a shivery little coward, you know?
Kavik suits me just fine, too, Pinky. Just the way he is.
I'm just asking, Kurt. I'm just asking.
I know, Pinky. I'll see you.
We'll see you. Like father, like son, I always say, Lloyd.
That's just about it.
Yep. Put this in the till, will you, Lloyd?
Andy home yet?
I haven't seen him.
Kavik! Come here, Kavik. Kavik? Kavik!
Well, there he is. Andy.
Is Kavik here? Those dogs are out there. They didn't see him,
listen,
did they?
Listen to me, son. George Hunter came today, and he took Kavik.
Oh, took him?
I tried to tell him he wouldn't listen to a word I said. He says nobody's gonna pull the wool over George Hunter.
Well, where'd they go?
Son, they left on the Copper Queen 10 minutes ago.
Andy?
Andy, there's nothing you can do about it.
Take a good look, Kavik. This is where you live now. Edna?
Yeah?
Edna, this is Kavik. Isn't he marvelous? There isn't another dog like him. If you looked, you couldn't find one like him anywhere.
What are you going to do with him?
What do you mean, what am I going to do with him? He's mine.
Well, you can hang him up in the wall, then, next to your walrus tusks.
This dog won one of the toughest races in Alaska.
Why couldn't you just have left him there?
Why? He's going to love it here. Wait till he sees the dog run I built for him. Come on, Kavik, I'll show you the run I built.
Please see he doesn't get into the flower beds. Mac just had them tilled, and they're to be seeded shortly.
Hunter?
Well, yeah, I guess so, but
Wouldn't you rather remember the dog as he was with us? I mean, Kavik's a part of Mr. Hunter's life now.
Well, I don't think writing a letter's going to hurt.
I just want to find out how he is and tell him how I am.
Some things are best left in the past, son.
It's just a letter, Dad.
Andy, go ahead, write the letter.
What's wrong with Dad?
Well, Daddy misses Kavik, too.
Mac, what's wrong with him, Mac? He's not eating and, well, you know northern dogs. Is it maybe a change of climate or is something else wrong with him?
He's homesick. Lonesome, too. Exercise.
Well, exercise him, Mac. Do what has to be done.
Easy, boy. All right. Settle down. Settle down. It's a long way, boy. Too long. Farther than you could ever go. So quit breaking your heart over something that can never be.
Set a date, Steve, but don't keep changing it. You said no to summer because most of the members would be away.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, you were right. But this is the middle of October and nobody's away anymore.
Yeah, George, you're right.
I want this to be special. I don't want just another one of those Saturday night sportsman's dinners.
Sure, George. Hey, where are you? I can barely hear you.
Hold on a sec.
George? George, where'd you go? You still there?
Right here. Okay, Steve.
Mac, Mr. Hunter asked me to give you this. It's from the boy in Alaska who saved the dog's life.
Oh.
Write him a note if you wish. He's interested in how the dog's getting on. He really does look superb, Mac. You've taken marvelous care of him.
Thank you.
You will write to the boy, won't you?
Okay, I will.
Thank you.
Boy, it's okay. It's okay, boy. Atta boy. That's it, boy. There we are. You haven't been in here before, have you, boy? It's not much, but it's better than being left out in the rain. You know what this is, don't you? I brought when I came down here. You know what they wear in winter down here? Rubber boots.
and a rain slicker and a sou'wester hat. Not something like this. Don't need it around here. Useless. I just leave it hang there now. Some things, Cavett, it's best we just leave it like that.
I'll walk him today, Mac. I want him to get used to me.
Fine idea, Mr. Hunter.
He's looking much better, Mac. Much better. Come on, Kavik. We're gonna make Ed Brokaw's moose hunts look like kid stuff. We're gonna get you in great shape. Come on now. That's it. Come on. You'll be in great shape. Great shape, Kavik. Take a walk now. Get up and walk. I was standing there with a great, big, tough-looking dog lying on the ground, whimpering.
Hey, he's shaking like a leaf.
It was humiliating.
Easy, boy. It's all right. It's all right.
No, it's not all right, Mac. You know he's the star of the sportsman's dinner at the country club. What if he pulled another stunt like that? Well, they'd laugh me out of town.
Nobody has to know. Give them a look. They won't ask any questions.
Maybe you're right, Mac. We'll give him a look. Just a look.
This is a fine dog, Mr. Hunter. He won't let you down. He'll give a good show.
Mac, if I could, I'd call the whole thing off. But I'm stuck with it. So we'll get him ready. Do the best we can. The big races run for 2 or 3 days at 20 miles a day. We're talking about running at 17 miles an hour. Now, the day I was there, they were clocking teams at between 73 and 74 minutes for the entire 20 miles. No, not that slide. Change it. That's better. Thanks. Now, Kavik's time. Listen to this. Kavik's time was 71 minutes flat. Flat. Now, you don't train a dog for that. It's born in him. The stamina, the staying power. Hey, Brokaw, you know about staying power with your moose hunts? We all know what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Kavik.
Hey, Cabby, come back. Kavik! Kavik, come back. Come back, Kavik.
All right, come on, Steve. You have to come this way. Kavik, come on, boy. Come on back.
A couple of you stay at the door. He might head back.
Kavik!
Hey, Kavik!
Get over that way.
Come over that way. Come on with me. Kavik! Kavik, come back! Come on, let's not bunch up now. Spread out. He's got to be on the ground somewhere. Spread out now. Go! Hey! Kavik! Kavik, come back! Kavik! Kavik!
quiet, boy. It's me.
Mac.
Mr. Hunter?
Mac, have you seen him?
Well, I was going to check that wall over by the putting green, where it's low.
We'll handle that. You stay here. Kavik!
Kavik, come on, boy, come on!
Okay, boy. You can come out now. It's me, Mac. Now, this is it. Go get it. Do it for both of us.
I'll be remembering you.
Probably won't make it. Die on the way. But at least that's better for the likes of him than staying here.
I'm afraid I don't know what you're talking about, Mac.
Yeah, I think you'll find him out back of the building on the dock.
Oh, thanks very much.
Good luck.
Come on.
Well, he said he was out here, on this side. Well, let's take a look around here. Give me the net.
Okay.
this stuff. Give me that stuff.
Okay.
Fella, you better watch it. It's a free ride you're looking for. This is a bad ship to be on. The old man, he don't like stowaways. You better just lay low. I'll bring you some grub when I get a chance. Okay? Good boy.
Go. You're old enough to forgive him.
I forgive him, Mom. I just don't feel like being friendly with him.
Ah, silly.
Yeah, it gets to me too, boy. We'll be docking pretty soon. Now, if you want to stay with me, you can. But if you want to go, that's all right, too.
Thank you. Dear Andy Evans, I owe you an apology for not writing sooner. I should have let you know about Kavik. But I didn't know what to say. Mr. Hunter found out about Kavik being a coward.
Andy, Laura, look, here's a picture of Havoc in the Seattle paper.
What does it say?
Well, let's see. It says, Havoc, champion sled dog owned by Seattle Industrials, George C. Hunter, leaped through a glass window last night during a special program being held at the North River Country Club. The animal lead dog of the winning team of the sled dog races in Alaska is one of a kind of... A search was made for the premises... of the premises, but no trace of the animal was found. Police have been notified to be on the lookout for a dog which answers to the name of Kavik. No reward has been offered.
Well, no wonder we never heard from them.
I winged him.
Did you? Are you sure?
Phil! Phil! What happened?
Mind your own business.
Ah, the
heck
with you.
What's wrong with him?
One more and that does it.
I'll get it.
I'll do it. We're just about finished anyway.
Are you sure?
Yeah. You better go inside there and get your books. Be getting home. It's getting late.
Okay. See you tomorrow.
Incredible, but maybe he did make it from Seattle. He's taken a terrible beating.
Yeah, that's as I feared. He's wrenched. Well, I guess I'm going to have to put him under and then snap the hip back into the socket and put a splints on it and a bandage. And then 4 or 5 days, he'll be chipper. You had some terrible fights, haven't you, boy?
Cavick fights?
Oh, yeah, Kurt. Some real bad ones. You don't get scarred like this and survive unless you got real guts, you know. Oh, all right, all right. He's an amazing dog.
Vic, Do you really think he can make it 2,000 miles up here alone?
Well, I don't know. Look at him. I mean, you don't get scars and scratches like that from being flown up by bush pilot, do you?
Dr. Walker?
Mm-hmm.
Thanks an awful lot for fixing him up.
That's all right, Andy.
I'll pay you tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, well, splints and the shot and bandage, that's, it's gonna cost you a dollar.
Come on, Vic. You'll never get rich that way.
If I was wanting to get rich, I'd be living in Fairbanks or Anchorage and telling lies and wearing stiff shoes. Come on, Kerry, get out of here.
Oh. Right.
In any case, this dog's, well, he's deserved all the help he gets. What are you gonna do when Hunter comes back in a couple of weeks?
Oh, I hadn't even thought about that.
Well, I suggest you do. Get something worked out. I don't fancy patching up Cavick like this once a year.
This thing's got to be settled, Kurt. One way or the other, but it's got to be settled.
It will be. George Hunter's never going to break that boy's heart again. I can promise you that. Not as long as I can help it.
I agree, he's a coward. But nobody's gonna tell me that dog walked 2,000 miles just to be with your boy. I wanna know who brought him up here for you.
Nobody. Cavick did it himself. He took a terrible beating getting here, too. Worse than anything those mutts in town ever did to him.
2,000 miles.
I couldn't believe it either.
Well, the mountain range alone is more than any of us would want to fool with.
There he is. Take a look for yourself.
Cavick! I'll be darned. He made it all right. What's left of him? You want him for your boy? We'll have to make a deal. I see I paid about $5,000 for him.
That's an awful lot of money, Mr. Hunter.
That's what I paid.
I've got some trapping money saved up, Dad.
Mr. Hunter, I don't grudge you the $5,000, but Cavick isn't worth that now. You wouldn't pay that for Cavick now.
No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't pay. Name a price.
Well, maybe we could afford $250.
$250?
That sounds fair, right?
Wouldn't make a house dog now.
$250. All right, Evans, you got yourself a heck of a bargain.
Mr. Hunter, I'd just like to say thank you.
You should.
Well, there you go, Andy.
I thought Mr. Hunter was never going to send this.
Well, legal papers take time to prepare, son. But it was worth the wait, wasn't it?
Sure was.
Look, there's your mom.
Mom! Look what I got! Kavik's mine now. He's really mine.
Well, looks like we got ourselves a dog.
I'm glad.
Kavik!
Oh, hi, Kavik.
Come here.
How are you, boy? Come on, how are you, son? Good dog. How are you, fella?
Hey, Lloyd. Old Andy's rabbit's back.
Good dog.
Kavik! Come back here, boy.
Kavik, come back here. Kavik, no!
Kavik,
come back.
You better get that rabbit out of here quick.
Kavik, run!
For himself. Holy mackerel!
I don't believe this. He could have killed him, but he didn't kill him.
He's fine. He's just fine.
Kavik, you won. Oh, you're such a good dog.
And I'm the one who said he could never do it.
Are you surprised?
No.
Oh, I love you, Kavik.
Let's get Kavik home.
Come on, Kavik.
You wait till Mr. Hunter hears about this.
Where's Evans?
He's right over there, sir.
Evans! Evans!
You put one over on me, Evans. You knew that dog was okay.
Are you calling me a liar, Mr. Hunter?
$250 for a dog like that is more than sharp dealing. You know it now and you knew it then.
Now you're calling me a cheat.
I can get that dog back, you know. Any court of law, any judge.
You want to take it to court? You go right ahead. I'll fight you. Wherever you take it, I'll fight you. If it's a fight you want, then that's what you'll get. You just say when and where.
You know what I could do to you, Evans?
Do you want me to take care of this, Mr. Hunter?
Pinky? You have something you want to say to me, huh? No, I didn't think so. So you just back off there and keep your mouth shut, all right? Now you, Hunter. Here and now, if that's what you want.
Evans, you work for me. This place is mine. The town is mine. The house you live in is mine. Evans, I could wipe you out.
Oh, no. You're never gonna wipe me out. So if it's a fight you want, you say so. Now.
Fight, huh? Fights. Well, it's not worth it. You want the dog that bad? He's yours. Keep him.
Mr. Hunter. Mr. Hunter! You had better mean what you just now said.
I always mean what I say, Evans.
So do I, Mr. Hunter. So do I. Come on. Let's go home. Yeah, Kevick, come on. Let's go home, son.
Come on, Kevick, come on.
Come on, Kevick.
Come on, Kevick.